these last 5 years of intensive research. Perhaps the most startling thing that I can share with you is that all of the conspiracy theories that you've ever heard about one world government, about the UN takeover of the world, all of those conspiracies have now been laid to rest. There's nothing conspiratorial about it. It's all published. The UN-funded Commission on Global Governance began meeting in 1992 in earnest and met for 4 years and last fall released their final report. It is entitled Our Global Neighborhood.
If the Bible is simply a book of myths, fairy tales, and stories, then it is disturbingly accurate in describing what we see unfolding in our current world climate. In my personal journey, I've come to the conclusion that the biblical worldview best explains the origin of evil and its many symptoms to mankind. It explains human suffering and the inescapable reality of death and decay that we experience in this world. But most importantly, it reveals why mankind has used deception as its most powerful and reliable instrument to carry out the plan set in motion by an ancient hate. Alex Jones, in his film Endgame, Blueprint for Global Enslavement, summarizes the sacred mission of the global elite as, quote, to have a two-class system where the underclass are forced to live as slaves in tiny enclosed cities, while the elite enjoy the land of the earth, evolve into superhumans with the aid of implantable technologies, live eternal lives, and travel the cosmos. This is the promise given to the inner members of the New World Order and the agenda of the Bilderberger Group, end quote. This sacred mission of the world elite has been the primary motivation for the establishments of several layers upon layers of systems in this world. The following sectors are the major components of infiltration in this plan. They include the political, economic, military, scientific, educational, technological, and social facets, with the spiritual ideologies being the main ingredient guiding this massive deception. Many of these facets overlap and build on each other. Using these various components of human society, the world elite are tirelessly working to allow the formation of a one-world currency, massive depopulation, a one-world religion, and of course, a one-world government. With the speed at which things are changing and evolving, never in human history has this plan been more attainable than today. But as I sorted through the many tentacles of this plan, I found that not only are we, the people of the world, victims, but the people who promote and continue to instigate the New World Order and the promise of a new age are perhaps the most deceived and are the ultimate victims.
The idea of what the ultimate goal for the New World Order is something that bothered me a lot in my early and really a lot of my research for what the New World Order was, as I was learning things like, you know, the stuff in the food and the water and all the stuff that you learn, you know, the genocide and the planned population reduction and the mind control and all the stuff that was going on. What did it all mean? What was it leading up to? The control grid, you know, the cameras and the one world government and the one world economy and all the stuff. What did it mean? Because the thing that got me is, What happens if they get it? You know, what happens if they finally control everybody? It's a total lockdown, New World Order, 1984, Brave New World, whatever. It actually is that system. What then? You know, is it all going to just end and everybody sits back and they drink lemonade and say, hey, we did it, guys. But then the connection to Satanism is really what started to pique my interest early on. And that they were theistic, you know, Satanists. They really did believe that Satan was God, and they actively